Welcome to this platform, Better Free Group of Schools, e-learning on the Soviet government, SS1. Today, the topic of our discussion is party system. Please want to know the meaning of party system, the types of party system that exist. As time will permit, we'll take the characteristics, merit, and demerit. We're just beginning the topic today. In a subsequent class, we'll finish the topic. What is party system? Party system is a political constitutional arrangement, or if you don't mind, a constitutional political arrangement on which political parties are formed for the purpose of governing a country. The constitutional political arrangement on which political parties are formed for the purpose of contesting election and governing a country. It can also be referred to as the basis for which government is formed on political party atmosphere. In other words, the formation of government on political party basis. That's what party system is talking about. You know, in the previous class, we talked about political party, which are organization of like-minded individuals who aim at gaining political control of the country, governing a state. Now, political parties exist on the platform of party system. Party system is, it talks about the platform, the basis. It talks about the number of political parties that exist in a state for the formation of government purposes. Now, there are different types of political parties that we have in existence globally. We all mentioned a few of them. We have, number one, the zero-party system. We have the one-party system. We have the two-party system. And then we have the multi-party system. Now, for today, we'll take the zero-party system and the one-party system. The zero-party system is a type of party system in which no political party exists in a country. In other words, a state or country that operates zero-party system, it means that in that country, there is no political party existing or that exists in that country. Rather, selection or election of candidates into office is based on personal recognition and other attributes of the individual as it enters. Now, what are the characteristics or merits put together of zero-party system? Zero-party system, all over the world, in most cases, you don't have it practically applicable all over the world, especially in Nigeria. But in zero-party system, number one merit is that election of candidates to political parties, into political office, rather, is based on the recognition of personal attributes. What the individual is known for, his past record, is something that tells whether he will be voted for or not. Number two, there is no political party that exists in that country or in that state. And then number three, advantage of zero-party system is that there is no waste of economic resources such as money for the conduct of elections or for that is being voted to political party as subvention for the sake of funding elections. There is no waste of money in that system. Election is conducted, just go, the candidate that wants to conduct election after, that wants to contest election rather, after the government have stipulated and brought out the qualifications, and whoever that meets up with the qualification goes to a designated ministry or agency that the government has appointed, picks his or her form, and then begin to contest our campaign on his own personal base without it being on the platform of any political party. But however, they have disadvantages in this political party, in this party system rather. One of the disadvantages of this zero-party system is that the input that political parties usually have in the political system, such as constructive criticism, political education of the people, of the masses, of the political activities, is absent, is missing in such a system. So, and then number two, the possibility of bringing up somebody who has been under tutelage of the political party ideology may be missing in the process of the political stream. So these are some of the disadvantages in a party system, in a zero-party system. Now, number two, one-party system. One-party system is a type of party system in which only one political party is constitutionally permitted or allowed to exist for the purpose of forming government in a state. In a state or country where only one political party is operating, okay, let's use that word, not constitutionally now. A system where only one political party, a state where only one political party is existing, we say that state has one party system. There are two types of one party system. We have the de jure party system and the de facto one party system.
That the Julian one party system is a type of one party system in which the law, the constitution permits only one political party to exist. So any other political party that comes to exist is considered as illegal and in most cases not permitted to do so. The de facto one party system is a type of one party system in which the constitution did not permit, did not give, there is nowhere stated in the constitution where only one political party should exist. But one party, or rather one political party is existing because situation warranted it. There could be different political parties existing in that country. For instance, Nigeria experienced one party system by de facto from 1999 in most cases, especially to 2011, 2015, where although we had multi-party system, we have many political parties existing, but only one political party like PDP, for instance, was in existence, was majorly powerful enough to contest and win most seats in the nation. So what have I said? Two types of one-party system, the jure one-party system and the de facto one-party system. One-party system that the constitution gives support to, that only one party must exist, that is the jure system. While de facto system is a type of party system where the constitution is silent about how many parties should exist, it not say only one party should exist, but situation warrants that it's only one political party that is existing. That is the jure one-party system. The characteristics of one-party system, which from where we can derive the merit and demerit, is that only one political party exists, which can either be according to law or by situation. Number two, in a one-party system, the political participation is low compared to multi-party system. Number three, characteristics of the one-party system is that there is only one ideology in the country, one political ideology, and that ideology is the ruling party ideology. And then number four characteristics is that in a one party system rather, the only party that is constitutionally recognized is also the ruling party, and so on and so forth. We can multiply the characteristics. Then any party that tends, number five, that tends, anybody that tends to organize any political party to come up, such act is referred to as treason. In other words, planned against the good and peace of the country, which is a punishable offense by the constitution in most cases in most countries. These are some of the characteristics of one party system. We're going to meet next time, but before we meet, your practice exercise is going to be this. What are the advantages and disadvantages of a one party system? One party system, the merit and demerit of it. Till next time we meet, remain good. Thank you.